Good afternoon and welcome to Bader Gymnasium at Westwood High School for the Westwood Fontbonne game. The first game for both teams in the Riley Classic this year. The first game was won by Archbishop Williams over Wellesley in a very close game, 65-63. Both teams having a very strong season. Fontbonne Ducks, led by Coach Claire Murphy, coming in with a record of 15-3. As we get set for the player introductions. Okay, an excellent rendition of our Star Spangled Banner by Shea Farrell, not only a tremendous singer, but also an excellent athlete here for Westwood High School. This is Mark Jessup, joined alongside Chris Giovino.
Good afternoon, Mark.
Good afternoon, Chris. What better way to spend a winter afternoon than enjoying some basketball between two very good teams. Let's set the starting lineups for you. For the Fontbonne Ducks, Annabelle Leonard, a captain, number 4. Tasha Lima, number 10, a freshman. Clarissa Garzon, another freshman, number 20. Ariane Sauvignon Howard, number 24, junior. And Leah Simmons, number 33, a senior. And for the Wolverines, Allie Morin, number 4. Haley Connaughton, number 10. Number 13, Elizabeth Kelly. Christina Bonfiglia, number 15. And Fiona McGowan, number 21. And here's the tip. It's out of bounds, and the ball goes to Westwood. This is Connaughton will enter to Morin. Fontbonne enters into what looks like a man-to-man.
What do we got?
Or a woman-to-woman. Ball feed into Kelly, the quick left-handed hoop. Westwood jumps out, 2-0. Westwood also dropping back into a man-to-man or a woman-to-woman defense, and a quick cut and a feed.
Oh, nice cut.
Rebound by Kelly. She's out to Connaughton. Connaughton back to Kelly. Over to Morin. She'll reset the offense. Connaughton screen across. Connaughton drives. Flips back and it's intercepted by Garzon. They'll look to transition and pass overhead of Sauvignon Howard. Westwood comes into the front court, probing that right side. Here's a ball screen. They got the switch. Morin reverses the ball.
Yeah, they gotta get it into Kelly, take advantage of the switch there.
I thought that's, oh, a nice drive by Bonfiglio, but it bounces out. Rebound to Simmons. Fontbonne on the run. They'll hold up and transition and reset the offense.
I'll be interested to see the matchup between the two point guards. Allie Morin is an experienced senior. And
nice move inside by Captain Annabelle Leonard on the pivot. And all tied up at 2.
And we'll see how the freshman Tasha Lima does.
Another ball screen and a steal. Okay. And here's Tasha Lima with the run out and a finish. Interesting, Fontbonne having a strong season starting 2 freshmen.
Yeah, definitely. Although pet peeve of yours, Mark, might be the right hand on the left side on that layup.
And I think that's going to be a travel. That's a nice move inside, which took one extra step. That's Kelly.
Just coming off a Player of the Week nomination. Needham Bank, Westwood Media Center's Player of the Week for the girls.
Oh, another screen in the back cut, partially blocked by Kelly. And here's Morin. She'll hit it ahead to Bonfiglio. Cross court to Kelly. Ooh, had Bonfiglio moving back door. Here's Morin with a left-handed drive and the kick out, and just over the head of a cutting McGowan. A little miscommunication on the wing there. 4-2 your score, 5.5 left, just getting started. Plenty of time to come down and enjoy some action at the Riley Classic. It was stolen by Bonfiglio. She's on the drive, she's in transition, she'll pull it out. She'll bring it back to Kelly. Cross court to McGowan, she turns and faces, hits Kelly on the drive, but tipped away. Fontbonne will hold it up, get things started. That's number 20, Garzon. Freshman guard, number 4, Captain Leonard up top. She gives it to Simmons. Cuts in. Nice move. Can't convert. Westwood controls and brings it into the front court. This is Morin. One of 4 senior captains for the Wolverines this year. Connaughton screens for Bonfiglio, who launches a 3. That's no good. Kelly controls and takes it up. A lot of contact there. No call. Fontbonne controls, and they'll push the action. Kicked away by Bonfiglio to hold up, and it'll be sideline out of bounds for the Ducks.
No calls either way. No fouls so far in this early in this game.
Very clean game. Both teams well-drilled, well-coached. Looking to probe the defense. cross court pass to Simmons. And she runs into her own teammate. Moore in controls. She'll run it out. She's cut off. Oh, down the lane nice with move. The scoop, and it's tipped away, and there's our first foul of the game.
There we go.
Warren goes to the line for two.
Fouls on number four, Annabelle Leonard. Or Larnard, actually.
First one rims out. We have our first sub of the game. It's number 15. Co-captain Amanda Cristiani. She enters for Garzon. That rims out. Controlled by Fontbonne. Here's the pass up court to Amanda. She drives to the hoop, up and under, and is fouled by Connaughton.
She had the angle on Haley, and there wasn't much she could do in that position.
Yeah, very nice. Cross court pass up court to the run out. Cristiani front rims it and it bounces out. And here's a second of two. More subs for Westwood. Number 23, Riley Murray enters the game along with number 14, Caroline Bean. And the second shot is no good. Controlled by Connaughton and tipped out by Fontbonne.
Very nice box out by Riley Murray there. She had good position. Allowed a teammate to come in and help get that ball.
Fontbonne extending the defense.
First press.
This little three-quarter court zone trap to Murray in the corner to Bonfiglio. She'll left fly. Ooh, front rims. Rebound, long rebound by Morin. Bean. Drive. Bonfiglio drives. Back to Bean. Over to Connaughton. Good ball reversal. Here's a ball screen from Murray. Kicks to Morin. She'll drive left. Good defense and lets fly from the top. Another offensive rebound. Connaughton for three. No good. And that's tipped away. Saved. Nearly saved by Murray. But, oh, that's Caroline Bean. Great hustle in the corner. Must have just stepped on the line. So we'll go back to Fontbonne. Westwood doing a great job on the offensive glass, kicking out for wide open threes, but can't convert to this point. A lot of good looks so far. Westwood drops into a little bit of a 2-3, it looks like.
Do a little crop the trap there, looked good.
Great job, both these teams doing a nice job changing defenses.
Well, that could
and
be,
yeah. Took an extra step on there, ball was tipped away. Number 24, Sauvignon Howard. Here's Connaughton with the ball.
Oh, nice skip pass.
Skip pass and back to the other side. Bean lets fly. Just off. They're getting really good looks. Here's in the corner to Sauvignon Howard. She'll drive up and under. No good. Bean with another nice rebound on the weak side. Connaughton enters the front court. Looking to probe. In the corner to Murray. She's cut off. Kicks it back to Morin. She drives. In the corner to Bean. She'll drive on the baseline. She's cut off. Ball reversal. Drive in the middle. Kicks it out to Connaughton. She'll let fly. And another long rebound for Westwood. In the corner, Bonfiglio tries to control, but it's tipped away by Larnard. So Westwood ball. Fresh shot clock. Warren to the top. Crosses over in the lane. Kicks it out. Bean lets fly again.
Oh, boy.
Iron unkind. And Fontbonne on the run out. Here's a beautiful pass cross court. Blocked.
What a
block. Blocked by Murray. Murray to Bonfiglio. Westwood enters in transition. Little stutter step to the line. Pull up jumper. No good.
Ooh, thought we might have some contact there.
Here's Larnard.
Let it go.
To Murray. Connaughton steps in. Little contact there, but she's able to convert off the glass. Beautiful, nice flurry of action there. Mm-hmm. Westwood's getting some great looks. Can't seem to connect. I think that's their game.
They'll start to fall.
Here's Murray. Murray cross court. Beautiful. Sort of jump hook there. Pull the Wolverines within two. 6-4 with a little over a minute left to play in the first quarter.
Sophomore with a strong move.
Here's Larnard from the corner. Nothing. Long rebound. Another nice rebound on the weak side by Bean. You always got to get those weak side rebounds. Okay, Warren resets the offense. 15 on the shot. Drives left-handed, and she finishes. Ooh, a little bit of contact there. Bump on the run out. Another nice block by Murray. Getting it at its highest point. Here's Morin in the corner. She'll left fly and
gotta go.
No good. Another offensive rebound. Pass intercepted by Wampon and stolen again by Bean. Boy, she's been active.
What persistence to stay after that.
Morin will left fly another one, and there's your first.
There it is.
That breaks the seal.
There we go. Now we can start raining them down.
10 seconds left here in the corner. Wampon gets stolen by Morin. 7 seconds to go. She'll drive to the hoop. Oh, and loses it.
Just never had control of that ball.
Never had control.
3.7 seconds left. 7-6.
End action here in the first quarter. Mm-hmm. Here's Larnard. She lets fly from the top and it irons out. Pretty good look there for 3 seconds left.
It was.
Okay, welcome back. Start of the second quarter here with Westwood leading 7-6. We're going to reset the lineups for you here in a second as Fontbonne enters the front court. Reverses the ball to Howard. Looks like most of the starters back in for Fontbonne. Post-entry pass. Shot. Oh! And that's a three-pointer for Larnard.
Shot. She had that one at the end of the first quarter that didn't go, but.
So for Westwood, it's Bean, Murray, Morin, McGowan, and Amanda Nocera now in the game. Here's Murray, she looks.
Oh, nice flash,
Looks like she had
it. Had Bean flashing.
Another drive and kick for Westwood. Back out to Morin. Six on the shot. The crossover
and
the run, and can't convert on the left-handed drive. And it'll stay Westwood ball. Here's Elizabeth Kelly coming into the game for Murray.
Fine effort by the sophomore Murray.
With McGowan up top to Bean. And they'll put it right into Kelly, fresh off the bench. Her shot is off the mark. There's Larnard to Howard. Sauvignon, and that's a blocking foul.
Who'd they get there?
Number 21, Fiona. McGowan. Sauvignon Howard makes the first of two. Put the Ducks up 10-7.
First made free throw of the game by either team in the fifth attempt.
Lead stands at 4-11-7. Wampon stays in their three-quarter court trap. Westwood had no trouble with that. They quickly reverse the ball. Oh, quick drive. Then the pass to Kelly, and she puts it in. That was Nocera, who got baseline, beat the rotating defense, and fed it to Kelly for a nice finish inside.
Very nice feed. Westwood has great composure. It's got an opportunity to see a few games this year, and they don't get rattled by the pressure. And
they've done a really nice job identifying the changing defenses. Another drive by Larnard. She'll flip it up. She follows, controlled by Bean. Bean again on the glass for the Wolverines.
She's clean.
In the corner to Sarah, she'll shot fake and drive in the finish.
Very nice drive. Strong take.
Now Sarah with two aggressive drives, attacking the defense. Oh, and here's, it looks like a little bit of a Westwood looking to trap on the outside. Drive by Larnard, she'll kick it back to Simmons, and Simmons hits. Nice ball screen. rotating into the empty space vacated by the defender, and Simmons hits the J. 13-11, Fontbonne. Warren settles. Probes the left. She'll bring it back out. We don't want to get caught in the corner. She'll reverses to Bean. Bean cross court to Nocera. Nocera drives. I think Amanda feels like she can beat her defender. Into Kelly. She'll turn in the middle and draws a foul. And a shot just rims out. She'll go to the line for two. Westwood looking to even things up with about 5 minutes, a little over 5 minutes left in the second quarter.
Well, the pace quickened with about a minute or minute and a half left in the first quarter, and it's continued here in the second, and the shots are starting to fall for both teams.
First is good for Kelly. And here comes a couple suds. Subs Bonfiglio and Connaughton comes back in. Warren will get her first rest of the day, and Caroline Bean, who was a real presence on the defensive glass and the offensive glass, getting a well-deserved rest. Here's Kelly for the second and two. It rims out, but looks like
Fiona, I think.
That was Fiona.
Almost got a piece of that.
Almost came up with it. Just tipped away the last second. Here comes Fontbonne. This is Tasha Lima, freshman point guard, controlling the action. Ball screen for Lima. She'll let fly from 15. No good. Controlled by Bonfiglio. Westwood looks to transition. Five out. Flash by Kelly. And it looks like it's going to be backcourt violation. Oh, yeah. So for Fontbonne, this is Sauvignon Howard ready to enter. You got Simmons, Larnard, Lima, and Garzon. I guess that's their starting five in the corner. To Larnard, cross court to Simmons. She continues to drive up and under. Oh, nice move. Keep on Figlio on the cut. Can't let those ball side cuts, no face cuts, coach. Here's Connaughton down the lane. Oh, no, I'm sorry. That was McGowan.
McGowan, yep.
Here's Kelly back out to
Sarah and into Kelly.
Sarah into Kelly, tipped away. Here's Larnard with an aggressive drive down the lane and draws contact. So I think there was two defenders there and she split them. A little miscommunication on the defensive part. Thought the other was going to. Taking in the first one's good for Larnard. She's picked up the aggressiveness in her game also. Number 15, Amanda Cristiani, co-captain, enters the game for Fontbonne, and Morin comes back.
Fiona's picked up her second foul.
That was the second foul in McGowan. And Larnard hits. Fontbonne pushing the lead out to five.
Larnard has seven quick points here in the second quarter. Accounting for most of her team's scoring.
Connaughton drives.
She felt like she was hit. And
looks like that ball was partially blocked.
Okay.
Connaughton looking for a little piece of the hand.
Mm-hmm.
I guess the ref thought hand's part of the ball on that one.
Yeah.
Okay, this is Nocera. She'll enter in the corner. She's got Kelly on the roll.
Kelly.
She flips to the middle. Rims out. Scramble for the loose ball.
Stays Westwood possession.
Oh, that's a... Was that Nocera back on the ground there? There's a Tommy point for her.
Absolutely.
Gaining an extra possession for Westwood. Bonfiglio to Connaughton, back to Bonfiglio in the corner. Rims out. Rebound. Controlled by Simmons. She gives to Lima. Advances into the front court. She'll reset the offense. This is a tough cover for Nocera. Into the back screen. Kelly picks it up. Nice switch. Nice cut. Another nice cut. The up and under and rims out.
Nice job by Haley. She had her hands full with a much taller player. She did a good job there.
Lima's done an excellent job keeping Allie Warren out of the paint on the offensive end.
She sure has.
And here's Bonfiglio. She'll nice move there. Catches iron, rims out. Westwood continuing to get good looks at the basket. Just a little off on their shots here. Good motion here by Cristiani. On the slice cut off the high post. And she converts.
19-12 with under 3 minutes left.
Ball screen. Kelly pops out, catches it, rescreens. Here comes into Kelly from Connaughton, and oh, another one off. But Nocera, another great rebound. Gaining yet another possession.
Interesting. Smart play.
Subs for Westwood. Bonfiglio and Nocera will take a seat.
Smart play by Amanda. She had the ball, and as she was falling to the ground, she didn't want to be called for that travel. So I thought she was successful throwing it off of a blue player, but we're 90 to 100 feet away, so hard to.
I agree with you. I thought that was going to be Westwood ball. Here's Lima in the corner.
Oh, nice.
Tipped away by Bean again. And that's Sauvignon Howard with the reach in, stopping, probably a wise play, stopping the run out by Westwood.
Absolutely. That evens the foul count at 3-3.
Just want to mention number three, Carly Segrew, into the game for the first time. Along with Bean, Caroline Bean.
Another senior captain for Westwood coming in to help provide some leadership.
Bean, nice ball reversal to Morin, but Lima's right in her pocket the whole time. Back out to Segrew. She'll ball fake. Kicks it to Morin. She'll take a look. She'll continue her drive. Sit to the corner. And here's Bean.
That's a good
one. And another good look. Rims out. Simmons controls.
Pick it up.
And inexplicably,
yes.
Simmons drops the ball, hearing the shot clock buzzer go off. She must have thought that was a shot clock violation. Dropped the ball for the ref, and it rolled out of bounds. So it'll be Bean entering.
I haven't seen anything like that at the high school level in a long time. That reminds me of the young kids when they're playing different courts and too many whistles, and they're not sure which whistle goes with which play.
Oh, and they court. The kids stop and look around.
Yeah, that's kind of what that looked like.
Next thing you know, the team's going the other direction.
That's too bad for Simmons.
All right, 1:45 left in the second.
Westwood not able to capitalize on that, though, unfortunately. Ooh, a freshman from the corner.
Lima from the corner. It bounces out. And here's Segrew. The ball to Morin. Over to Segrew. She gets her first clean look and buries it. That's a big hoop. Brings Westwood back within four.
First shot of the game. 1-for-1.
Westwood struggling with their shooting, but doing everything else very well. Their aggressive defense. They got the trap. Oh, and they let her out.
Oh, got a double dribble call in there.
I was screened on that. Double dribble from the quick pressure. 1:15 left. Warren enters the front court. Looking for the double ball screen. Jimmy Chipwood play at the top of the key. She's got Larnard on her. And here's Segrew. And she shuffles. Looked like she wanted to take it to the hole, and Warren filled her space.
Felt like Westwood wanted to move quicker than they had to there. They've been patient all game, taking advantage of the shot clock, doing the drive and dish, and not rushing things. But
yeah, just looking, trying to look like make something happen here.
Under a minute
left. Back into their zone, trapping defense. Tipped away by Connaughton, but Simmons grabs right back. Here's Lauren on the top. She'll reverse. Number 11. That's Larkin and Howard with a nice drive. Splitting the defense.
Nice drive. I feel like she took a bus. There's a lot of traveling going on there.
Oh, the crossover by Morin. She'll bring it down.
Nice.
Flips it up and in.
Yeah.
Beautiful move by Morin.
Allie's first field goal of the game. She has a three 20, earlier.
20 seconds left in the second quarter. 21-17. Pom-pom. Here's a quick track. Bean and Connaughton enters it in the corner. And a great rotating defense by Segrew tips it away. Here comes Bonfiglio for Connaughton. Looks like Westwood's going man-to-man underneath.
A little more size, too.
Into Howard.
12
back to Larnard. Kicks it out to Amanda. She can't control. 6 seconds left for Westwood.
Down four. Let's see what they have set up here, Mark.
Coach Cliff calling out ace, so we'll see what this is. It's a quick dribble drive. I think Morin can beat her. She's going to get right down the lane. Kick to the corner.
An extra
and
kick.
Extra pass, and it's no good. They had an excellent look from Segru, looking to make her second three-pointer.
Good look.
So at the end of the second quarter, 21-17.
I don't remember seeing her.
Okay. Getting ready for the second half tip. Westwood down 4 to Fontbonne Academy from Milton.
I'll do a quick reset of the first half scoring. Annabelle Larnard with 9 for Fontbonne. Tasha Lima with 2. Amanda Christiani with 2. Sauvignon Howard with 6. And Simmons with 2. For Westwood, Allie Morin had 5. Elizabeth Kelly had 5, leading the way. Segru had that 3-pointer. And 2 for Riley Murray and 2 for Amanda Nocera. I'll give you the 17.
Okay, it looks like both teams going back to their starters. Benfiglio with the ball in the wing. She'll drive left. Stutter step. Over to McGowan. Back top to Morin. She'll reset. Cross court to Connaughton. Into Kelly. The hoop. Scoop to the hoop.
Drop step. Yeah. It's got to shoot it. It didn't hit rim.
And that's up.
Oh, no,
and
that was good. Oh, come on. Oh. That was good. That was
oh,
in the air.
Oh, and the refs are going to talk about that one.
I think one of them saw better. That was in the air. I hope they give it to
like
her.
That ball was in the air.
That was in the air.
He didn't ask for help, and he calls it off. We'll have to look at that one on the tape later.
I wish they could go to the table and look at the tape now.
I know.
Oh, that's too bad.
So, in the end, shot clock violation. Back to Fontbonne. Looking for the trap on the side. A scramble for a loose ball. It's still alive. Morin comes out with it. She's got McGowan ahead of the field. She'll take it herself. Kicks out to Kelly, lines it up for 15-footer, and good. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Maybe that'll spark Westwood a little bit going here.
I'm thinking the same thing, Mark.
They saw the ball go through the hoop 2 times. Back to Howard on the wing. She'll let fly. Saved by Larnard, but already out of bounds. That was great hustle down the other end. I saw 3 Wolverines on the floor. That loose ball before.
Westwood's been consistent with the effort. They've been getting on the floor, getting after that ball. They see a loose ball. They're not shy to try to get that and get control.
Looking to get the ball into Kelly.
Kelly going left-handed.
Scoop across.
Very
Kelly
nice.
Kelly with another one.
Her last drop step was to the right, so she's mixing it up there. And
tie game.
Whoa.
Near steal by Connaughton.
Yeah, she was.
And here's back to
sneaking around
to
the backside.
Cross court into Simmons. She'll drive down the lane. And travel called. Could have had a jump ball on that either way.
It's hard for a fan and a coach, I think, when they perceive a missed call. And the next one, they want to make sure that the refs see it in their favor here. McGowan in the corner.
Tough baseline jumper. Doesn't fall. Yep. Fontbonne with a run out. Cross court. Here's, ooh, nice. Pass from Lima to Larnard. Can't commit. Warren pushes. She drives, kicks to Connaughton. She'll let fly from the right wing. No good. McGowan tips. Controlled by Warren. And it's into Kelly again. She'll scoop.
A lot
of contact there. Late whistle, but they got the right one, I think. Maybe 2 shots for Kelly as Westwood. Look to put Westwood in the lead for the first time in a while. That'll be timeout for the Ducks.
First time out of the game. And I think we'll take one here as well. Yeah, the refs were...
Okay, here we go. 5:44 left in the third quarter. All tied at 21. Kelly going to the line for 2 shots. Both teams sticking with their starters. Westwood playing a lot more players in the game thus far. We'll see if that pays off going down the stretch.
I think they went 9, maybe 10 deep in the first half.
First for Kelly. Westwood looking to get the ball inside to establish an inside-out presence a little bit more. Beginning of the second half, paying dividends. Kelly makes her... Rims out.
Second attempt.
That ball's controlled by Garzon.
early in the
third. I'm going to put the ball in Garzon's hands, yeah. Get Lima a little bit more on the wing.
Early in the third, Kelly accounting for most of the points, or all of the Westwood points.
A little misconnection.
Not just all of Westwood's points, all of the points in the game, in the quarter, actually, for either team. So
here's Cristiani back in the game for Lima.
Nice more in.
Pomfiglio. Sugar around the rep. Fiddles, diddles, look to get the ball into Kelly again. And tipped away, controlled by Cristiani. Over to Simmons. Back to Garzon. She'll hit Larnard on the right wing. Larnard resets the offense. Only five on the shot clock. I don't think that shot clock got reset.
That can't be right. The refs need to look at that. I was happy for Westwood that they might get the ball back sooner, but it doesn't seem right, and they'll do their best to get it close.
And the Wolverines looking for an opportunity to sub. That's Murray and Bean back in the game.
Both did very well in the first half, and they're
Westwood brings minutes. A lot of energy in off the bench. That's into Simmons. She'll look to spin move. Beautiful move. Connaughton comes away with it. She'll look to push. Got Bonfiglio on the wing. Stutter step at the top. Kick to the corner to Bean. Back up top to Bonfiglio. She thinks she can take her defender. Jump stop off the board and in. Nice move from Bonfiglio.
She thought she could, and she did. Oh.
Owen Warren. Really doing a nice job, the pressure defense. Here's Larnard, kicks to the corner to Cristiani. Baseline jumper, no good. Another rebound for Bean. Bonfiglio brings into the front court. She's looking for an opportunity. Step back three. Off the front iron, no good. Garzon controls. Warren goes down. Eyes up court, Larnard. Gets to the wing. She'll kick across to Howard, and Howard lets fly. No good. Another rebound for Caroline Bean. Fantastic job. She gets it out. Now she's got the ball back to her on the court. Up top to Morin. Morin comes around the ball screen.
Turns the corner.
Avoids the defense. Puts it up. No good.
She beat two players there, Mark, and the third one came over. So there wasn't much she could do about that. What about deflection?
Deflection. Mm-hmm. Bonfiglio and Garzon on the floor. And that's a tie ball. That'll stay with the Ducks. Used Nocera in the game for Morin. Took a hard fall last time down. Westwood leading by three. 3.5 left in the third quarter.
Outscoring Fontbonne 7-0 this quarter, so.
I don't think they can leave Lima on the bench too long. Nice drive from Simmons, but she moved the pivot foot before she got going. And the Ducks extend the pressure again. Here's Connaughton and Bonfiglio in the backcourt. Into Bean, cross court to Connaughton. She'll let five from three, and no good. Simmons controls. Over to Larnard, up court. To Sauvignon Howard, and she's fouled going to the hoop. Nice pass up court.
That one's on Caroline Bean, her first.
Very clean game, just two fouls. Here in the third quarter so far. The first is good. And Lima back for Simmons. Coach Murphy for the Fontbonne Ducks. Giving everybody a quick break. Sauvignon Howard for a second and hits. 1-point lead for Westwood.
Oh no, nobody's in the middle for Westwood.
And there's a deflection. By Larnard. 24 left on the shot. Bonfiglio inbound from the wing. Back up top to Connaughton. Oh, the ball bounces right to Bonfiglio. She found herself a little too far into the hoop. Couldn't convert. Here's Lima. And she's fouled going to the hoop.
Looks like it's going to be on Haley.
Norton tried to step in, drove the charge, got there a little bit too late.
Yep.
Second on Haley. And the first for Lima's Goods. We're all tied up at 24. Coach Clifford very, very lucky to have some experienced guards. When one is out, they have no problem running their offense. So the Fontbonne Ducks fight back. The aggressiveness getting to the hoop. Canoten and Bonfiglio rotating the ball. Bonfiglio will drive. Off board and off the iron. Stolen by Canoten.
Oh, good persistence. Surrounded by three Fontbonne players. She maintains possession. Comes up dribbling from her knees and calls the timeout.
Coach Clifford close to the play.
That's Westwood's first timeout of the game. Coming here at 2:28 left in the third quarter.
So 1 point margin.
For Fontbonne. Both teams have only used one timeout, so those are some strategy things you start thinking about in the second half.
No one in foul trouble. So here comes Westwood. It'll be Bonfiglio, Nocera, Bean, Connaughton, and Murray. And it does not look like any changes for...
We're calling the triangle play.
Up top to Murray. Back in the corner to Bonfiglio. Simmons will play her. Ball screen for... She gets rid of the ball screen. Double screen up top. Back to Connaughton. Connaughton drives, kicks to Bean. She'll left fry from the wing. Iron rims out. Another rebound, Simmons. Here's Lima. And she'll look to reset the offense up top. Westwood staying in a woman-to-woman defense. And ball screen. Howard down the lane and lays it. Oh, rims out. Beautiful left-handed drive.
That's some good luck.
Here's Bonfiglio around the back. She looks to beat Howard. Kicks to Bean up top to Connaughton, and she shuffled. Looks like she wanted to let that one fly. And here's Morin and McGowan back in. Mm-hmm. Connaughton and Nocera will take a seat.
Westwood shooting still kind of cold. But they're right in this game.
Playing aggressive defense, and here's Howard down the lane again. Rims out. Simmons with the rebound. That's no good. Another opportunity bounces out. Here's Warren up to Bonfiglio. She'll drive. And she gets the angle and lays it in. Beautiful move from Christina Bonfiglio.
Rim protectors for Fontbonne were not back. Christina identified that right away and saw
Warren,
she could get to the basket.
Warren putting a lot of pressure on. On the Fontbonne guards.
It's a second foul on Caroline Bean. I didn't see the offense there.
Here's Kelly back in for Murray.
55 seconds left in the third quarter.
Back up top to Lima. She turns and faces. She's covered by Bean. Cross court to Garzon. She'll drive. That rims out. Fleury for the loose ball. Another rebound for Fontbonne. This is Sauvignon Howard. Tipped away. Controlled by Kelly. Bonfiglio to Morin. Morin sets the offense. 30 seconds left.
Reach. Good.
And we got a reach by Lehman. She did not like the call.
That's her first of the game.
All right, fresh shot clock. So the shot clock is off. The end of the third quarter. Into Morin. She drives Lima. A lot of pressure. Ball screen there. She's got it. The roll from Kelly. Looks like he got an advantage on Kelly inside. Bonfiglio drives.
Yeah, they do. There we go.
And another reach by Lima. So both teams with three fouls 16.9 to go. Bonfiglio calls a play.
Good situational basketball by Westwood to identify the mismatch. And
Beans got it. She turns, faces left, fly. No good. Rebound, Fontbonne. This is Sauvignon Howard. She'll drive up with the left hand. No good. Blocked by Bonfiglio, but they're going to call her for hitting the arm.
I'm sorry. Every time she has that ball, it looks like she travels when she's going to the basket. To me, that's the third time she gets a head of steam up. I feel like she maybe picks up the dribble just a little earlier than might be natural.
So two shots for Sauvignon Howard. I feel like she's been at the line a lot today.
Well, she has. This will be her sixth attempt, and she was perfect until that shot. So Westwood hoping she.
You know what they say about free throws. And that one's good. Sauvignon Howard, 5 or 6 from the line, and it's all tied up, 26. And
let's get this off in a hurry.
Half court shot is no good. So at the end of 3, 26 all. Okay, here we go. Beginning of the fourth quarter, it is 26-26. It'll be Westwood ball inbounding. Fontbonne sticking with their starters. For Westwood, it'll be Morin, Segru, Connaughton, Kelly. Oh, tipped away. Lima's got it. Over to for Howard. She lets it up, and she's fouled by Morin.
Sally's first fourth team foul, or fifth team foul, looks like on the board. Must have missed one there. So, Mark, what do they say about free throws?
Well, we'll see if it proves out to be true in this fourth quarter, but it's often the difference between winning and losing.
Ah, there you go.
And Sauvignon Howard proving that to be true. She looks to extend the lead. She now 7 for 8, I believe, from the line.
She is indeed, yeah.
And Westwood, 2 shots from being in the bonus. Tipped away. Morin re-gets it. Here's Carly. Kelly drives. Gets the feed from Segru. And the hoop. And the harm, as they say. Westwood's been most effective when they've gotten the ball inside to Kelly.
Kelly's
especially in the second half.
She's accounted for 12 of the Westwood's 28 points so
That's
far.
Second foul on Garzon. Cristiani re-enters for her.
Still nobody in foul trouble for either team. No one has more than 2 fouls each.
Oh. And irons out for Kelly, and we're tied again at 28. Larnard, here's Larnard. She's been quiet for a while.
She has.
Cross court to Lima. Back to Larnard.
Clearly a talented player.
Looks for the ball screen from Simmons. Back in the corner, Sauvignon. Howard. Simmons lets fly from the top. And that's 3.
It's Fontbonne's only 2nd three-pointer of the game.
Simmons has got a nice touch from the outside.
Matching Westwood for only.
Here's McGowan. She looks to hit a cutting Connaughton, but they can't connect. And the ball goes back to Fontbonne. Looks like Larnard will inbound to Lima.
I say that 3 matches Westwood's.
Looks like we had a little bit of a 2-3 trap here. Lima lets fly. Ooh, calmly sinks 15-footer. Fontbonne jumps up by 5.
Yeah, Westwood's going to have to respond
Kelly.
Here.
Cross court to McGowan. She'll drive.
Don't force
looks
it.
To enter to Kelly. Back to McGowan. She drives to the hoop. Tipped away. And Kelly can't connect. Larnard comes away.
Oh, they had 2.
They had 2 cracks at it.
Yeah, they did. Good 2 defense. Bites of that apple.
Lima resets. This has been a nice matchup. Lima against Morin. Morin looking to pressure her. Into Cristiani. The back cut. Back to Sauvignon Howard, and she can't convert. Here's Morin, and the run out. She's got McGowan and Connaughton with her. This understep, blocked by Larnard.
I thought she had some arm, too.
And here's
maybe
Lima.
I was just hoping. Oh, that's got to be a charge.
That is a charge.
All right.
Kelly steps in on Lima.
Now that is Lima's third foul.
That's great defense.
Fifth team foul.
Bonfiglio comes back for McGowan. Beautiful drive from McGowan there. Just couldn't get it to go. Fontbonne extending the pressure.
Look at the ball, Carly.
Okay. Court. Oh, nice move by Segrue. She'll drive.
Oh, surprised. Refs have been consistent. They haven't been calling those bumps all game. And
they got to keep taking it.
Yep. Just got to keep taking it strong. And
oh, and it's another.
One. They took it away.
They wave it off. Another charge. And that'll be Lima's fourth.
That was huge.
I didn't have a good view of that one.
I had a pretty good view.
And that's timeout Fontbonne with a 5-point lead.
Oh, great.
And that gets the Westwood crowd into it. 5.5 left in the fourth quarter. Fontbonne with a 5-point lead. Tasha Lima just picking up her fourth foul.
They leave her on the floor, too.
Interesting decision by Coach Murphy.
It is.
As they continue with their three-quarter court, just looking to burn a few seconds for Westwood. Here's Segrue. Lowers the shoulder, kicks to Kelly, back out to Connaught, and she lets fly, and that off the front iron. Connaught having a tough day from the outside, but
Coach
give
Clifford,
her credit. Give
Coach
her credit
Clifford signaling to use her legs maybe a little bit more on those shots.
Give her credit for keep shooting it. Because you know, as a shooter.
Shoot.
You got to shoot till you get hot. And when you get hot, don't stop. Okay. Here's Larnard. To the hoop. Kelly gets it, and they call her for travel.
Unfortunate.
Ball goes back to Fontbonne.
Just
still leading by five.
Just under 5 minutes left. Yep, plenty of time, Mark. Yep.
Plenty of time. Sauvignon Howard enters the ball. And it goes into Christy. Simmons. She can't connect. Here's Morin. Picked up by Garzon. They took up. And a drive from Connaughton. And a little show and go there. Not sure about that one.
I'm not either. I thought I had a good look at her feet. I thought she hit the ball hit the hard court before.
Back to Fontbonne. Here's Sauvignon Howard up top now with the ball.
But I don't have stripes or a whistle. So.
Oh, beautiful back cut.
So nice.
Oh! Looked like there's some contact on that shot. But here's Sauvignon Howard. She continues to attack the basket. And that's good. Oh, 7-point lead for the guests. Three-quarter court trap has not led to any steals, but has sped Westwood up a little bit. They'll get the ball into Kelly. This has been their best matchup. She'll scoop. No good. Larnard comes away with it. Up to Sauvignon Howard. Back up top to Larnard.
Oh,
she'll attack the gap. And
it strips. Oh, off of blue. Well, I don't know about that.
Okay.
Christina knocked it off of
it looked like it knocked Fontbonne's off her leg, but
knee, yeah. Well, Fontbonne player's knee.
That's at the other end of the action. Fontbonne enters to Sauvignon Howard in the corner. She turns, faces, looks, gets the ball inside the Larnard. She turns and faces, pump fake. She'll attack back outside. 11 on the shot clock. Baseline drive. Good defense. Blocked by Kelly.
Yeah.
Ball will stay with the Ducks with just 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Looks like Coach Kelly calling for a man-to-man matchup. Here's a back screen. They can't get Simmons. Tipped away again. It'll stay with Fontbonne. Sauvignon Howard will look to enter. Only one tick off the clock there. Same play. Back screen. Cut to the corner. Tipped away. Looked like Sauvignon Howard touched that ball from out of bounds. So let's fly. No good. And that's a violation. Ball back to Westwood. Down 7. 3.5 to play.
Coach might want to think about lengthening the game a little bit, keeping an eye on our timeouts, and see how they do in this
possession. This is Warren, left-handed dribble. She draws the foul. That'll be the seventh foul, so Warren will be going to the line for 1-1.
Okay, Westwood's going to have to start to earn it at the
Westwood
line.
Westwood needs to cut into this lead from the foul line. Lima comes and enters back in for... Well, that was Mary... Comes in for Mary Ryan, number 21, who had entered the game. Good block out by Cristiani. Nearly stolen by Morin. Garzon up to Larnard in the corner. And another drive by Sauvignon Howard. Pushes the largest lead of the game now for the Ducks. The number 9, nearly a steal. McKelly. Nice drive, but blocked by Larnard. And let's Sauvignon Howard lets fly from three. No good. And that's a foul on Cristiani over the back. And this will be Segrue going to the line.
Westwood's going to need to start to earn it from the line. It's, they can knock them down. You can start catching up with no time going off the clock.
Give you a chance. If you make these free throws, it gives you a chance to set up your defense.
That's going to be important as we get down the stretch in these last 3 minutes.
As we see the Wellesley boys enter the game, getting ready for their matchup against Silver Lake coming up after this game.
Westwood's taken 10 free throws this half. And
that's good. Two for Segrue. Westwood drops back. I thought they might look to extend the pressure there with under 3 minutes to play.
Westwood 4 for 10 from the free throw line. Fontbonne 11 for 12.
Fontbonne setting some back screens. And it's to Larnard. She'll look to drive on Segrue. Twists, turns, kicks to Lima. She baseline jumper. No good. And it's a scramble for the loose ball. And looks like that ball's going to stay with the Ducks. 2:27 to play. 7-point lead for Fontbonne. Lady Wolverines in the bonus. Here's a cut from Larnard. Up and under, and oh, that's a nice move. Got the defense spread a little bit, and she made a nice internal cut. Here's Connaughton against the press of Fontbonne. Warren gets the screen from Kelly into Bonfiglio. She turns faces, looking for Kelly, but the help defense was there, and Larnard comes away with it.
He overshot her just a little bit, unfortunately.
Fontbonne looks like they're going to burn some clock here.
9-point lead, 2 minutes left.
Nearly stolen by Segrue. She's pressuring Larnard. Larnard over to Sauvignon Howard.
I'm surprised that wasn't a travel.
She's checked by Segrue. Stolen by Segrue. And looking for an and one.
Yeah, of course.
She's fouled by Sauvignon Howard. And beautiful steal bump for Bonfiglio.
Okay. There's a timeout here with 1:37 left.
Okay, let's resect the action. Lady Wolverines down 9, with just 1:37 to play. Christina Bonfiglio going to the line for 2 shots.
It's her first trip to the free throw line tonight. Let's hope she heats up quickly.
All right, you need to get these two.
Need to get these two
and extend then your defense.
Get into that full court. And they've been effective getting turnovers tonight, so I don't see why they wouldn't be able to if you're able to make these free throws. Fontbonne has 2 players with 4 fouls, so they have a little foul trouble, but clock is not the friend of the Wolverines at this point.
First one's off the back rim. Westwood needs this one to set up their pressure defense. Second one's no good. Tipped by Kelly, but it goes to Larnard. And Westwood drops back into the man-to-man.
They can play aggressive. They have a foul to give. So
here's Larnard. Bump on, just looking.
There we go.
Build the clock. That's taken away by Connaughton.
Okay.
The next one will be 1-1 for the Ducks.
It's Haley's third. She's the one. She has
Sauvignon Howard. She's checked by Bonfiglio. And that's in the Larnard. Lisa Brew checks her at the arc. Looks like they got a new shot clock on that. It goes to Cristiani. She looks to hit the cutter. They'll bring it back up top. And that's a timeout for the Ducks. With 16 seconds left on the shot clock. Just 1:06 left in the game. A little surprised Westwood's not looking to foul and put them at the line to lengthen the game and get a few extra possessions.
I am too. This is, other than Haley Connaughton, who has three, no one else has more than two. So you could certainly do that here with the foul to give.
To Bill Riley, long time, very successful coach of the Westwood girls program, spending 18 years, resulting in 9 undefeated Tri-Valley seasons and 4 sectional and 2 state championships. Great way to honor a great coach. So, 1:06 to play. 9-point lead for the Ducks from Fontbonne Academy.
Well, you don't want to foul Sauvignon Howard if you can avoid it. She's...
I'd say she's probably player of the game. Her ability to not to get to the get into the paint, draw contact, and take advantage of those shots.
I'm still hoping Westwood can have a player of the game.
And they can. Looks like they changed the strategy. The Bonfiglio fouls Larnard. She'll go to the line.
That's only Christina's first foul, so smart play there. 58 seconds. Might have done it. Larnard's second trip to the line. She was 2 for 2 in the second quarter.
And it works. Success.
Pays off.
Off the back.
Unless we get the possession back.
Here's Connaughton.
There you go. Don't have to get them back all at once. Just want to get good
That's
shots.
That's Bonfiglio in the corner and spot. Off the front rim for Morin.
Mm-hmm. That's her spot.
Oh, the Westwood's done a fantastic job of getting into the paint and kicking to their shooters on the weak side. Just have not been able to knock enough shots down. I can only think of a couple that have fallen for them today. Oh. Usually they've game. They've done a nice job on defense, sharing the ball, and on the rebounds.
Yeah. Well, Westwood's only hit two three-pointers. Carly Segru hit one, and Allie Warren hit one. That was it.
Here's Lima at the line.
That last foul went to Haley, and unfortunately.
No good again. Out to Bonfiglio. She's picked up by Lima. She'll drive, the crossover gets in the line, and tipped away, and it's another foul. Cristiani now going to the line for 1-on-1. Next one will be a two-shot foul for the Ducks. 36.1 left. Our next game will be Westwood boys facing off against the Bishop Feehan. It's 7:00 on Sunday night. And, that's an offensive rebound, Larnard. Long rebound there, picked up by Larnard. She takes it right back up.
Westwood's strategy paid off. The Fontbonne Ducks got cold at the line right when we needed them to, but unfortunately,
We haven't been able to connect on the other end.
Exactly. And now with two shots coming, it's easy to be a little bit more relaxed as a shooter when you know you've got two. Larnard with the first and with the second.
Are you speaking as a former free throw shooting champion?
Former free throw second place. I think.
Well, there's the bump on Sauvignon Howard.
I think you might have a better experience of the championship end of things from the free throw line. This is going to be the fifth foul on Sauvignon Howard. But with 28.8 seconds and 11-point lead, both teams in double bonus.
She's getting a nice round of applause from the Fontbonne Duck faithful. And this is number 11, Sarah Larkin, a sophomore re-entering the game.
Well, she leaves with 15 points, and Haley Connaughton at the line, and calmly knocks down that first one. On her first trip tonight.
And
Carly poked it up there.
That's a jump ball going back to Westwood. Segru earning an extra possession for the Wolverines. And they'll call timeout.
This is going to be, that's a third timeout.
Well, that's a valuable opportunity for Coach Clifford to set up an out-of-bounds play. Mm-hmm. You know, entering end of the season, getting ready for the tournament. These end-of-game possessions, maybe practice a little something that might come in handy in a big game coming up over the next week or so.
That's right. As you mentioned, Westwood's qualified for the playoffs. And those seedings come out this Friday.
It's an exciting time with both boys and girls teams advancing to the state tournament. Their other half.
Yeah, they've been doing that all year for each other. And the last several as well.
Well, it's all about making the den great again here in 2017.
That's right. There we go. Warren. Let's see what they drew up.
Cross to Connaughton. She'll turn back outside to Benfiglio.
Made a quick shot.
She'll step back, let it fly, and that's good.
Timeout.
Timeout Westwood. 17 seconds left.
Yeah. 41-34, 7-point game.
Westwood's going to look to get a quick steal or quick trap. And if not, foul again. Just trying to lengthen the game here, get a few extra possessions.
What do you think, Mark? A quick two? Just go to the basket if you get.
Silver Lake and Wellesley boys are here at the gym getting ready for their game to follow this one in the first leg on the boys' side.
So the winner of this game here will go on to face Archbishop Williams in action on Monday. And
that's a near steal for Segru, but she gives the foul to number four. That's Larnard, who's had a nice game.
Arnold has. She has 13 points so far, looking to add to that total.
But just a second off the clock here. First is good.
Second's good.
Ooh, nothing but net. Mm-hmm. Calmly sinking two shots.
6-for-7 for the game.
Connaughton, she'll drive. Kicks. And
too much stutter on the stutter step by Segru, unfortunately. And that ref's opinion.
And just 10 seconds remaining here.
10 seconds remaining. Westwood's going to call. They call off the dogs.
And Larnard advances in the front court. Back to Larnard. And there you have it. In a very well played game, the Fontbonne Lady Ducks defeat the Westwood Lady Wolverines 43-34. I'm Mark Chessup with Chris Giovino saying thank you.
So long.